Good evening, viewers. Welcome to People and Stories. Today, we have a special guest with a heart for children. She's called Estella Kabagaya. Estella, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for hosting me.
Okay. So tell us about Estella. How did you start, going out there and helping children in the market?
Oh, helping children didn't start with the market. In 2003, or even beyond, I've been helping children, both with reading, with playing. I love playing with children because I love to grow their personal development. So coming to the market was another part of me, which just spins from 2017. But I've been mama children. I've been a mother of all children for over 20 years. Yeah, so it's just that I came into the market space.
Okay, so tell us, children as a space, was it your calling from the get-go? Did you finish school and decide, I'm going to go and work with children? What's your background?
My education background, I have a diploma in accounting and a part professional course, ACCA. I'm a former banker with Stanbic Bank. But then when I resigned in 2009, I had a passion for children's growth. So I started with just doing it for fun, you know, collecting children, play with children, read to children, anything that had children in it was giving me a peace of mind. Coming to the market, I came to the market in 2017, and that is, I started with Wandegia Market. I wished to support the children, not necessarily with education, the children, the non-school going age, and those usually stay at home. So those ones belong to the daycare. So I'm passionate about those ones.
So tell us about how you came to choose Wandegia Market.
So I was taking a walk through Wandegia, heading to Old Kampala. Then I saw the letters at the back of south wing of Wandegia Market, third floor.
So The alphabet
on the walls. Okay. So the mama children in me wished to go and just say a rhyme or two, just sing for them. Going through the stairs, I reached and the place was empty. So when I asked those close to the daycare center, they said it had never been opened since the inception of the market. That was 5 years then. So they told me, but whoever wants, maybe they can contact the authorities and have it. I went through management, I went through city council, they sent me back to management. And that's how I ended up in 2017, setting up the first space for children in a market.
Okay, so when you got there, tell us what were the procedures? Setting up, getting the children, getting the parents buying, the mothers buying. Tell us, what was the procedure?
I worked with the market management. By then it was led by Mr. Jita. So I worked with them to do community mobilization and sensitization. So we went through speaking to the women. The women knew that space was around. And we're just waiting for it to be operational. So with the help of the management, we're able to visit the women in the different sectors, those in food, those in stalls, those in shops, to explain to them exactly what I was going to do so that they appreciate the service. Because we had to convince them that at last what they wanted was coming into reality.
But at that point in time, as you were convincing them, did you see them with children?
Yes, I did. I kept on looking, especially I felt so much for those who are in food section because there is fire. It's the most high risk space in the market. So I knew the children were there, but just to convince the parents that you need this space. And also there is what we call human centered design. You have to design depending on the customer need. So I had to tell them that what I'm doing will benefit them, and we come to a 50-50. Yes, I'll trust you with my child. Yes, I need care, I need safety. Then yes, will the money be that? Will it be worth it? Yes. So we also agreed on how much they were supposed to pay.
And that was how much?
That was 3,000
3,000 shillings?
Yes, per day.
Per day?
Yes.
And that is something they said they could afford?
Yes, they could, because these are women who earn less than 10,000 shillings a day, 7 to 10,000 shillings. So if she's lucky, especially the people in food, they don't own the spaces. So they have to earn from another person. They earn per plate. So the more plates she sells, the more money she earns. And each plate is 1,000 for her. So if the child is let go, then she'll be able to move more plates, so earn more. However, also if she can sell, because of the competition in the nature of business, she can sell 7 to 10 plates or more. So you look at it and you're like, how much can then she put aside for childcare? So that's why we came up with that fee.
Okay. Setting up this center, did you get any support from KCCA? Where did you get the funding for?
Passion was way beyond anything I could listen to. I wasn't looking at the benefit, overrode everything. I was blind. I was crazy about having this space run. I took a loan from my husband, which I had to convince him with all the nice words, because he wasn't making sense, economic sense, financial sense from what I was dreaming. It was my own dream. Actually, I would say most financiers, most accountants, even me, I was like, it's not going to make money the way any business should do. But to me, I was looking at first impact, because when you give people value, money follows value. I was like, one day, the money will come. But then at that time, you couldn't tell me anything. I really, really needed. But also, I believe that if I got the niche right, I would get the numbers. And once I got the numbers...
How many did you start with?
I started with about 15. Yeah, 15. And by that, the numbers kept growing. But also remember, I'm taking non-school going age. So when they clock 3, I ask the parents to take them for more education. And they bring in the younger ones. Yes, so anyone who clocked 3, basically this center takes the 0 to 3. So we do what you're supposed to do at home. Play, potty training, cognitive skills, teach them how to socialize, sing, make friends. It's not a formal kind of setting, but then we prepare them because we teach them the colors, the alphabet, the basic ones. So when you get them in school, they're ready to go.
Okay, now composing your team, what is the criteria for the minders you
hire? Yes. One, my rule is I hire attitude, I train skill. But then also me, I'm not a trained ECD professional. I did it out of passion. So I had to get a supervisor who is qualified in ECD. But then this is not a school, so I don't need a degree holder for nursery. I need a diploma, I need a certificate. Someone who can understand the children, then pass on the information. So then for the child minders, I would take at least a minimum of S4, because they can understand, you can communicate to them, and they're easy to tell whether they'll pick the skill or not. So that was my criteria.
Okay. Do you give them some orientation to see if at all they have the love for children, they have the spark? How long is that?
Now, with that orientation is 2 months, and you learn on the job. We watch you.
What are the must not do's,
you must never use your hands against a child, and use your voice, because children are very sensitive to anyone who barks at them. Yeah, you become enemies from day one once you bark. So your voice is very, very instrumental. And also you play with your voice to communicate. You can make it sweeten, you can soften it. And they're like, okay, yes, you can make it firm. Yeah.
Okay. Never to raise a voice.
You don't never raise
never
a voice.
Never to hit a child. Okay. Yeah. Now from Wandege, tell us about your move to other markets.
Wandege, I was affected by COVID. Oh. COVID came in 2020, visited the whole world in 2020.
So, like a project.
And first thing first, all kids were expected to be back home.
True.
So inclusive of daycares. So we had to close in 2020 in March. And we sat back home and relaxed and chilled. Year one, year two. When the petition went through and they allowed the children below 6 to go back to schools. That means even us who take below 3 were allowed to reopen. However, I wasn't lucky enough, because of change in administration, to work with a new administration in Wandege Market. So I found it hard, but because I was resilient and I love what I do, I had to find ways. I moved my staff and first took it home. Luckily for me, there was an innovation challenge by the Aga Khan Foundation for ECDs, and I grabbed the opportunity. I tried to convince them that yes, the vulnerable business women also need childcare support. But at that time, I was looking at Kasubi Market, which wasn't yielding very fast, and the program had a time limit. So I dared go for the ghetto. So I set up a space in Kamocha down in the ghetto.
Past the Catholic church?
Past the Catholic deep, I would say in the middle of the ghetto.
Oh.
There I started, that's where I implemented the Aga Khan Foundation.
What's the center called?
It's still Mama Children.
Mama Children. Okay. So it was for women in the market or now general?
You know, when you look at a slum, it looks like a market. Everything is a shop, everything is a market, everything is business. So to me, I was like, yeah, these women, they may not be very organized like in the market. It's more organized, you know, whose stall it is, but they required the service. We did a sensitization. We went through Q&A, what do you need, how do you need it? Whereas the space there is limited.
True.
Limited, but we found somewhere in the middle where we could squeeze, and we have about 15 children there.
Let's go for a short break. We'll be right back with Estella Kabagaya.